said, go down,
go down,
Moses,
Moses,
way,
way
down,
down
in Egypt land. Tell old Pharaohs to let my people go.
Only when I came to Israel, then I first heard it told that Elijah will come again someday. I have seen him, it's real, and I just can't help but feel how much closer his kingdom is today. Signs of the times are everywhere, and we in Israel can say without fear. And strifes on every hand, and violence fills our land. Still some people doubt that he's not the one, but the word of God is true. He redeemed his chosen few. Don't lose hope, King Elijah will see us through.
Some woman They got human ideals, they set it up, they named their church, and they got it going. So we say we are in the house of Israel. We have another name. And if we go into the Bible, we can prove that. But these other churches, that cannot take place. They cannot show you that. Now, look at the Bible in Ezekiel 39 and 22. Ezekiel 39 and 22. And when you find it, please read.
So the house of Israel,
yes,
shall know that I am the Lord their God.
Amen.
From that day and
forward. Just listen again.
Amen.
Just listen to what your Holy Bible just told you. Here it says a certain church shall know from that day and forward that I am the Lord their God.
Amen.
All we have to do is find out what church was that. And if we make them read, you see it says, house of Israel.
Yeah.
It didn't say Baptist. Didn't say Muslim. Pentecostal. It says, house of Israel. Look in verse 29. Same Ezekiel 39. Look in verse 29.
Neither will I hide my face anymore from them. For I have poured out my spirit on the house of Israel.
Amen.
That's the Lord.
Well, if the Most High tell us, I have poured out my spirit upon the house of Israel, we have another name. We are not listed among the hundreds of names that's in the world. We are the despised few.
Amen.
And I'm proud to be among that despised few.
Amen.
Read that verse again, my son.
Neither will I hide my face anymore from them.
Now they want to tell us that the Most High has hid his face from us because he was so bad. He done got rid of us. He don't have nothing more to do with us. He done passed us away. But when we are finished listening to what they say, let's hear what the Most High says.
Neither will I hide my face anymore from them.
Neither will I hide my face anymore from them.
For I have poured out my spirit.
For I have poured out my spirit
from the house of Israel, says the Lord God.
Amen.
And you know, to a person that can read, that is sufficient. Yeah, did you get through some? Okay. Oh, that yeah, slipped up on me. Yes. It was me that we know that we hold to the only true church. Then why all these folks in these other churches? They got pastors that they believe. They got pastors that tell them it's all right. They got pastors and bishops and reverends that tell them, long as you believe. Believe what? Believe what? yet, my Lord. I will appoint to the front to the bottom, my Lord, and warn to the pastures that scatter my sheep.
That is the pastor that they're talking about. You say he's not here? He's not scattering no sheep. He's gathering the sheep. Ask Billy Graham if he's scattering the sheep. Ask Thor Roberts if he's scattering the sheep. Ask Bishop T.D. Jakes if he's scattering the sheep. Ask Mr. Dollar if he's scattering the sheep. He's not here. I have 20,000 members sitting in my church every Sunday. 20,000 members sitting in my church every Sunday. Asking if Sunday the day the Most High gave for us to worship. He said, you quit, it don't make no difference about the day. You want to worship on the Sabbath, that's all right, but don't want to worship on Sunday, that's all right. I have one tell you that didn't make no difference. Let me ask you a question. Does making a difference whether God exists or not? Let's say, I don't believe there is a God. That's a belief. Is that all right? If I can believe anything I want to believe, why do I need God? I don't know if y'all get me on point. If they say you can believe whatever you want to believe, you just believe, then what role does God play? God tells me to believe certain things. God tells me to believe there is one Lord.
Amen.
God tells me to believe there is one faith.
Amen.
God tells me to believe there is one baptism.
Amen.
God tells me to believe that there is one God.
Amen.
Father of all.
Amen.
Lord of all. Through all.
Amen. Amen.
Now, am I right to believe it? Mm-hmm. So if I believe it's just one thing, and here comes the Reverend telling me, well, if you believe in Jesus, I don't know nobody that don't believe in Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
It's what do they believe about Jesus.
That's right. Amen.
Everybody believes in Jesus. And you and I must just hold fast and not get upset because we have all over the world, we only have a little small handful of people. The devil that's leading the folks astray will change their minds.
Amen.
The Muslim leader, what's his name, Mr. Louis Farzon, he doesn't change his mind. He says that Muhammad is not the last prophet. He's one of the prophets. He's a major prophet, but he's not the last prophet. The man on the television said, but that's the Muslim man gone. He said, well, I understand what they are saying. But Muhammad is not the last prophet.
Amen.
He said, the last prophet is alive.
Amen. Amen.
And here in America.
Amen.
The man asked and said, well, is that you? He told him, no. No, I'm not you. Still he's here in America.
Amen.
No, I know times he wouldn't have said that.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
So if we continue to proclaim the one name, the church has one name, House of Israel.
Amen.
Finally, you said it. I can read it from Genesis to Revelation.
Amen.
Man, I see what it says, Church of God. Bible named God.
Mm-hmm. You know for Satan is God.
Mm-hmm. Now, the world believes slightly that his name is Jehovah.
You know,
they say his name is Jehovah. Well, what makes a lot of folks believe it, it's in the Bible. And most folks say that if it's in the Bible, the word Jehovah is roughly only about 500 years old. Now, if the word Jehovah is only about 500 years old, if that's God's name, what was his name before 500 years?
Mm-hmm.
The Catholic Church is the author of the word Jehovah. That's a great deal of things that is inserted in your Bible. Jehovah is one of their words. But that's not the name. The Jehovah Witnesses in their book, let your name be sanctified. Page 16. I want you to listen to this. This is in the Jehovah Witness book. Let your name be sanctified. Page 16. Listen what they say. While we acknowledge that the name Jehovah is not the true name. Now listen to this. These are Jehovah Witnesses. They believe in the name so hard they done formed an organization on the name.
Amen.
Oh, what power. Now they said, while we recognize that the name Jehovah is not the original name, but the name Jehovah is more familiar to the people.
Mm-hmm. So you prefer the Bible.
He comes to us new things. Can you imagine this? They admit that. They themselves admit that.
Amen.
When they are known as the Jehovah's Witnesses.
And it goes on to show you how faithful people are when they're serving faithfully.
Mm-hmm.
True. Amen. Brother, my Lord, is that what it's going to take?
I don't have it. I wouldn't know about it, Brother David.
I would love to get that for my collection.
Well, you can check it out. I'm reading it from another book.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. The Witness book is Let Your Name Be Sanctified. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's one of their books.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can check it out. Probably
fine. But see, my Lord, half our people have to be destroyed because they can't be reached. You know, and they rather believe that name instead of, you know, let's find out.
When you say they can't be reached, who are you speaking about?
I'm talking about, you know, among our people, my Lord. Because they just
so
they
just
so.
When you say among our people, who are you speaking about?
I'm talking about the lost sheep of the house of Israel, my Lord. They're just so wrapped up in these religions and the name and everything else, they just refuse to wake up.
And they want to
get our soul that we're speaking about black folks.
Yes, my Lord.
So you're saying they don't know.
That's why, my Lord, they said, according to your word, it says two-thirds will have to be the school in the future. They're just too wicked.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Yes, sir. That is indeed and in truth.
Mm-hmm.
But let me show you what the words say about the situation. In 1 John chapter 4, in 1 John chapter 4, and start at verse 4 to 6.
1 yes. John chapter 4, verse 4.
Starting 4 to 6.
This is what it says. We are of God, little children.
Now, here is a group we are told they are of God. No ifs, ands, or buts. No maybe, no, it ain't none of that. 1 John chapter 4, verse 4 to 6. Read verse 4 now. Let me hear what it says.
We are of God, little children. Go ahead. And have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
So greater is the spirit that is in the members of the house of Israel than the spirit that is in the folks out in this world.
That's what it says.
Verse 5.
They are of the world. Therefore, speak they of the world.
You see, I was saying earlier here when me and the bishop was in a conversation this morning that the preachers that I was involved in dialogue with during the week, they defend the system. And when you start talking with a person, a preacher, a pastor, a bishop, or whatever it is, you don't need but 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you don't need that long. Mm-hmm. Once they open their mouth, what they are defending is going to come out of their mouth.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And that's what we're being told right there. What the verse 5 say?
They are of the world.
They are of the world.
Amen.
Yes.
Therefore speak they of the world.
When these reverends and pastors and bishops and when they start talking, they're defending what goes on in the world.
Amen.
This religious system, they do not see it as Babylon. They see it as it's all right, and you believe what you want to believe, and
my Lord, they lie so much that they believe in their own lies. Yes,
yes.
Oh, man.
So let us hold on to the word.
Amen.
And it says they are of the world.
Therefore speak they of
the world. Therefore speak they of the world. That's what they're going to defend. That's what they're going to tell you is right and true.
And
don't matter if it's not in the Bible. They're going to defend it anyway.
Amen.
Go ahead.
And the world heareth.
Listen what it says.
Amen.
And the world heareth them.
Amen.
The world are going to listen to them.
Because according to the word, they prefer darkness rather than light.
Yes, sir. Yes. They are of the world.
Amen.
And the world
heareth
them.
Amen.
Go on to 6.
We of God.
Amen.
We are of God. Now, what we started to get in verse 4, he summarized it in full in verse 6.
Amen.
In verse 4, he told you, you are God, your children. Did he tell you that?
Yes, amen.
Yes, he told you that. Ye are of God, your children, and have overcome them. I don't even like to get in conversations, and this kind of teaching about Babylon. But you sometimes will be talking about sound like they're giving them praise. And I have no praise for them.
Amen.
So in verse 4, he lets us know where we at. Mm-hmm. And now in verse 6, it's repeated again.
Amen.
What it says,
we are of God.
We are of God.
He that knoweth God heareth us.
You can tell whether they're of the world or they're of God.
Amen.
When you state what the word is and you say turn here and read it, they go accept it or they go start defending a lie.
Amen, amen.
We are of God.
Yes.
He that is not
he of God. He that knoweth God heareth us.
Amen.
The man or the woman that know who God is.
Amen.
They're going to hear us.
Amen. Amen.
They're not going to hear nobody else.
No.
If they know who God is, they're going to hear us.
Amen.
Now, go on. If they don't know who God is.
He that is not of God heareth not
they
us.
They're not going to hear us.
Amen.
They're not going to hear us. Why? With Dr. Dollar, hear me. When I got 6 members and he got 20,000. Why would he hear me?
Money, my Lord.
That's why he would hear me?
No, Sam. That's why he will not hear you.
Oh, no, man.
The Almighty Dollar.
Not only that, the evidence that he will hold that he is right is his 20,000 members. But you need to understand, Satan has more than 20,000.
Amen, amen.
Now, we were discussing the word Jehovah. Who in the clan can here be one place of the 4 places where that word is found in your Bible? It's 4 times mentioned in the Bible. Who can give me one of them or all of them? That word Jehovah. Anybody can give me one of them? Or all 4 of them? Exodus 6:3. That's the first one. You can make notes of it.
You will know what it is that.
Exodus 6:3. You may read it if you see it.
Okay. Everyone got it? Give me time.
Exodus chapter 6 and verse 3.
Got it?
Amen.
All right. Exodus 6:3. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob by the name of God Almighty. But by my name, Jehovah, was I not known to them.
You don't get that?
Amen.
I appeared unto Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob by my name, God Almighty. That is that. I appeared unto these men by my name, God Almighty. But by my name, Jehovah, they haven't known me. They haven't heard nothing about that name, he said. They don't know nothing about that name. That's the first place you find it in the Bible, okay? Psalms 83 and verse 18.
Psalms 83 and verse 18. Psalms 83 and verse 18.
83.
Psalms chapter 83 and verse 18.
Everyone got it?
That is where you find it.
Okay. That men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, art the Most High over all the earth.
Amen.
Now, these names were inserted by the Catholics. There is no word in Hebrew as Jehovah.
Amen.
There were no J's. There were no J's.
No vowels.
There were no J's in Hebrew, in the alphabet, Hebrew, Greek, or English. All three of them, they had no J. So the Catholic Church created that word, Jehovah.
Amen.
And had it inserted into the Bible. So you see two of the places right now, right?
Amen.
All right, there are two more. Isaiah 12 and verse 2. Isaiah 12 and verse 2.
Okay. Everyone got it?
Isaiah 12 and verse 2.
Ready? Okay. Isaiah chapter 12 verse 2. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also is become my salvation.
That's number three, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Now let's read the last one, which makes up four. Isaiah 26 and verse 4. Isaiah 26 and verse 4.
Got it?
Isaiah 26 and verse 4.
Everyone got it?
Amen.
Isaiah 26 verse 4. Trust ye in the Lord forever.
Amen.
For in the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength.
Mm-hmm. These are the four places that you find the word Jehovah. Now, you have to keep in your mind what we have taught this morning. In no Hebrew manuscript, there is no such word. How old did we say that word Jehovah was? Anybody listen to the claim?
About
500 years old. In other words, before that time the word wasn't known. So what was God's name? What's the name of the book where we were told that the Jehovah Witnesses themselves said not the true name? What's the name of the book?
Jehovah Witness Open.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What's the name of it?
That your name be sanctified.
Let your name be sanctified. Now I want you to learn in class. I don't want to be standing up here talking to myself. I got four adults in this class. So in Exodus 6:3, what name was the Almighty using when he talked to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob?
God Almighty.
God Almighty. I appeared to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. by my name, God Almighty, but by my name, Jehovah, I was not known to them. Well, so we see one of the Most High names, God Almighty.
Amen.
That's the name Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is. Yeah.
Yes, my Lord, there are so many titles that the Most High has, my Lord. So many of them.
Mm-hmm.
Thousands.
Not that many, but that many. Why? What's the point now?
I'm just saying, my Lord, you know, so many, but the, you know, but they, you know, the name hasn't been with it.
Yes, lots of them. Want to look at another one of his names, Mama. I think I'm going to have to come back there and talk to y'all, get you to turn around. Look up here toward me, Mama. The church is not that way. Turn around, look up here. Turn around. Genesis 49, verse 10. Genesis 49 and verse 10. We will see a name there. Genesis 49 and verse 10. Go ahead if you have it.
The script, the substitute.
The substitute.
The substitute shall not depart from you.
Now this is that.
No,
hold it, hold it, hold it. Can anybody tell me what is the substitute?
It's like a position of power, a royal scepter that is used the younger people with.
The authority, the power,
the power.
Rulership. Yes.
Or like a staff or something like that.
Stick they call it.
Mm-hmm.
Authority to rule. Now listen what this verse says, now that we know what substitute means. It means the authority to rule. Listen what the verse says. Read it again.
The substitute shall not be far from Judah.
Now, that is telling you who has the divine authority to rule.
Amen.
It's the Jew.
Amen.
The substitute shall not depart from Judah.
Nor a
lot. Hold it. It's not going to be Judah. I want y'all to really get this, you know. That's why I don't want to run through it. I want you to get it. The rulership shall not depart from the Jew. You know, you got some fools. They have to be fools. That said, the tribe of Judah, when the Bible said Judah, it is speaking about one tribe, the tribe of Judah. Now, when the Bible said Jesus was born, King of the Jews, are we to understand he was born, King of that tribe? Is that what it's talking about?
No, my Lord, he said all of the Jews. And
no. The Bible said he was born King of the Jews.
Yes, all of them.
Well, if it means Judah, and you got reverends and bishops and apostles and prophets, okay, that talks about just one tribe. And that's the tribe of Judah. So I inquired, does that mean that Jesus was the king of one tribe?
No. All of them.
So then this thing about meaning one tribe cannot be true.
Amen.
That word covered all 12 tribes.
Amen.
Yes, Brother David?
Yes, Lord, but it's okay. The scripture is saying that Judah is the head tribe, that none of the other tribes will elevate against Judah.
Now maybe that got something to do with what I'm saying. What is it? I said, maybe that got something to do with what I am saying. Tell me, what is it?
That the scepter will not depart from you.
All right. Do that mean the Jews, or that mean that tribe Judah?
Well, that means well, the all tribes.
All tribes. Because when you said Jews, you're talking about all of them.
Amen.
What tribe was Paul from?
He was from the tribe of Benjamin.
And he said he was a Jew, didn't he?
Amen.
He was a Jew. So let us learn that. When we say, and when we read in the Bible where it says, salvation is of the Jews. I know we don't believe that talking about a tribe.
No.
All of them.
All of them.
Amen.
Now let's finish reading Genesis 49 and 10.
The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come, and unto him shall the gathering of the people be.
Now that's beautiful.
Amen.
I tell you, that's beautiful.
Amen.
Somebody help me with the name Shiloh. What that means? Who is that?
God.
So,
yes.
So his name is Shiloh.
Amen.
Read that verse over again. That's a beautiful verse.
The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come, and unto him shall the gathering of the people be.
Now, whoever Shiloh is, it's unto him to be the gathering of the people.
Amen.
Now, that's why it's important you know who we're talking about.
Amen.
Because whoever is being gathered today, if they have little or no knowledge about Shiloh, you must be one of them that's not going to be gathered. So that was another title that applied to Elijah.
Amen.
Amen. How do you know what's talking about Elijah? It says, and unto him,
my men are flowing. Oh, there are some places that I cannot go. But I am sure of this one thing. Lord Elijah is real, for I can see him face to face. Oh, my God is real. Lord Elijah is real, for he has fenced and made us so. Oh, his love for us will never fail. Lord Elijah is real, for I can see his face. I cannot tell just how you feel.
Without